All right, it's time to get beat up.
Growing up, aside from all the acrobatic stuff that I did, I also did martial arts. So I did like taekwondo, tangsudo, some boxing, some kickboxing and stuff here and there. And while all that stuff is super fun and like very good and like just a good thing to know in general, another really, really cool martial art is Jiu Jitsu. And I'm really good at like, well, I don't want to say I'm really good. I am decent at grappling and like wrestling and stuff, but I never really did any real Jiu Jitsu classes. And my friend actually just opened his own Jiu Jitsu school. So I'm going to roll around with him a little bit today and let him kick my ass.
Stick him up against these walls. Make him work off the walls. Use the pattern that's in play, right? Think street, practice sport, learn the whole art.
I'm gonna fight him today.
Yes!
That's no!
That'd be a great idea. I'll teach you technique and I'll let you fight Leighton.
There we go.
Yay!
He'll probably still win.
More people to beat up.
Thousands of people will see this across the country, so you better not suck, okay?
My motivational
nice dad pep talk.
Yeah,
I love
that's
it.
That's right. Represent the fam.
Daddy, it's just one more person I gotta beat up.
Oh. Belt. Don't worry about the belt. I'll help you tie it, okay?
Okay, if it's the same as. Similar.
Square up. It's super easy. It's like karate.
Yeah,
right?
That's why I'm like, if it's similar, I haven't had a time to karate belt in years, but.
Well, if you come out screwed up, I'll help you fix it.
I will be screwed up. Right? I'm used to tag someone else's now. I always tag Brayden's. He's five, so it's like.
That's, just pretend it's the same thing.
Okay. I don't know how my knot is. It's been a while since I had the time my own, but.
A roll, we'll do some sausages.
You look a little like Cookie Monster. You don't even look like a professional tumbler anymore.
I'm a professional martial artist now, so.
I guess you start building again on December.
Nah. All right, dude. Welcome. So. That's good. That's not too shabby.
I mean,
generally what you want to do is put them together, right? Mm-hmm. So like you went under here, just go underneath both of them. So it stays together, right? Yes. And so I'm gonna teach you how to do what's called the super knot. A lot of karate places don't do this because they don't need to. People aren't pulling on their belts.
Yeah.
But if I go under, over, through, and then I feed it through the middle, right, between the two layers, then it does like the super lock,
there
right? And so then it almost never comes out. And I say almost because obviously people are fighting.
Sometimes, but yeah.
Sometimes. For generally, it doesn't come out at all. All right, cool. So jiu-jitsu is a little bit different, right? So we're gonna like shake hands. Hug it out.
Close
contact thing. Okay. No. We're gonna throw.
Are you gonna like, hug me and toss?
No, absolutely. So, no, you're good. Lay down. Sit down. So, what I'm gonna teach you first is like jiu-jitsu 101. One of the hallmark things about jiu-jitsu is your ability to like protect yourself from the ground. Right? When you're on your back, you can still defend yourself and win a fight. So, I'm gonna teach you two things today. I'm going to teach you, one, how to defend yourself against anybody trying to strike you, and then two, how to put a man down and you come up on top so you can either handle your business or get out of it. Okay? Cool. So, the first position I'm going to teach you is called the guard. So, lay on your back. So, when you're standing up and fighting, you put your hands up and you guard yourself,
yeah.
Right? Well, in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, your guard is your legs, right? So, you can have what's called a full guard where both your legs are in, and your guard essentially is to monitor the space in between me and you. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
If I start to press in too much, you don't like that, you can keep me out,
mm-hmm.
right? If I start to try and reach.
I might need, I don't know if I should put on a band-aid. I just want to get, like, I have a little bit of a cut right there. I don't want to get blood on this if it's not.
No, you'll be fine.
Okay.
We're not going to fight that hard. You shouldn't start bleeding.
We are going to fight that hard.
Me and Leighton, not you.
Yeah. In a little while, I'll give you a chance to work your skills, all right? So cool. So your guard, I push in, you push out.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Just kind of monitor the space. It makes it hard for me to hit you.
Yeah.
Okay? So I'm gonna teach you the three different layers of guard, right? So the first layer, real close here.
Mm-hmm.
I can hit you, you can't really hit me.
Yeah.
Right? So one of the things you want to do is catch my head and my arm and then hold me nice and tight, close your legs around my hip. Right? Right there, it makes it very difficult for me to hit you. I've got one arm.
Mm-hmm.
Now I can hit you. You're not gonna stop me from doing that, but you're gonna mitigate the damage,
mm-hmm.
okay? So, one more time, legs around my hips, and I want you to pull me into that position. Ready,
okay.
Go.
Good, yeah?
Ready, close your guard. Set, go.
Good.
One more time. Ready?
Good.
Second layer is going to be your knees on my biceps, right? So what you're going to do from there is go knees on the biceps, and your hands are going to go behind my triceps, outside your knees, just like that, right? Mm-hmm. So now you can ride. So what happens is sometimes hugging into our first position, head and arm.
Okay.
Right? Sometimes the guy will start really getting the to get a good punch in on you. So what you're going to do is fill that space with your knee and move your hand to my tricep. Boom, right? Mm-hmm. So now you can kind of ride. Keep holding my arm. Boom. And you can fill the space with your other knee. Boom. And now you can ride. Put your feet on my hips, knees on my biceps. And now it's really difficult for me to hit you, right? Now drop me back into the first one.
Boom. Push me out to the second one.
Good. Drop me in.
Push me out.
Nice. Right? So stage two. Stage three. I start standing up. You clear the space with your feet. Keep me out, makes it hard for me to hit you, right? Hands defending yourself, you're tracking me with your feet. Very good. If I come with a huge haymaker, drop me all the way into stage one.
Boom, yes. I'm working. Stage two.
Good. Stage three.
Stage one. I'm getting you on the ribs. Stage two.
Yes, stage three. Nice. Awesome. I'm gonna teach you what's called a balloon sweep. You can catch my wrists, get control of my hands. Good, start to bring your knees in some. Let me get over top of you, right? If I start pressuring in, you're gonna use your legs like a slingshot and back roll right over, ready, go. Boom! One more time. All right, so you're up here tracking me. You get your hands, you just wanna kind of cut my arms, right? Boom, boom. Using it, keep the hands. I want you to tuck them into your pockets. I want you to roll with me and end up on top of me.
Okay.
So you go in and over. Boom! Nice. Again.
Okay. He's the king of the world.
All right. Last time. Good deal.
You're out of shape.
What?
Stage one. Go.
Defend yourself. Don't let me step over. Good. Stage two.
Good. Stage three, catch the wrist. Oh, good, get your feet on me. Go, boom. Oh no, pin me, sit on top. Thanks, good. Yeah, uncle. Legs to manage the space so that you can manage the damage. And that suit's called a balloon sweep. Up and over, okay? It's pretty nice. Works particularly when they go in. Every technique is an answer to one problem. So obviously that won't work every time, but if you have somebody leaning in, you can get control of their wrists and you can feel that they're leaning on your feet, you can take it for a ride, all right? One of the things that you want to try and do, stand up, is once I get the wrists and I'm monitoring your feet, I mean your hips, excuse me, with my feet, I need to feel you pushing, because if you're backing away, that isn't it.
Yeah.
I need you to, I got to ride me. So you got to push. I've got to give you a little bit of pushback, right? In every situation, right, there is what's called a push-pull dynamic. If I push you, you're probably gonna push back to me, right? Because you're gonna resist that. So when I'm pushing, you're pushing, and then I collapse, right? I get you to trust my legs.
Yeah.
So when you can use that, you'll make what's called an effortless sweep, right? So I use the push-pull dynamic. I get you, you're trying to swing at me, you're doing the thing, you're up, I ride with you, I follow. Right, from here, you're gonna take my arm, put your hip behind my shoulder, sit over, and hit your arm lock.
Armbars
for breakfast. Let's go. And then feet on the hips. Very nice. Get control of the wrists. Nice. Get me to pressure a little bit. All right. So monitor that. There you go. Boom. You go over to mount. Bring my arm across my body. Get your knee behind my head. Boom. Step all the way over. Hi-ya. Dope. One more time. Up and over, slide over, boom, boom. Nice. All together now. You're good. Stage one.
Good. Stage two.
Nice. Stage three. Balloon sweep. Boom, arm bar. All right. Cool. Now it's time to put it to the test, arm. Are you ready? I've got this killer.
Oh no.
The baddest dude in the gym. Taps everybody out. All right? I saved him just for you. Okay? All right.
I don't ever take this off, but I don't want it to get ripped off.
Are you ready? Come on. All right, here's my killer. He's gonna put it on you, okay? He's not taking it easy or anything. Layton, you know Mr. Daw. All right, you ready?
I'm kinda nervous, I don't know if I'm ready.
Shake his hands, slap. So when we do jiu-jitsu, we go slap and bump. Just like that, all right? Slap and bump, boom, okay? All right.
Am I starting down?
You're gonna start just like that. Layton's gonna go, you know, all right? Ready?
I don't know.
All right, go. Good. Working that guard. Passing, Layton. Up and over. Base, good. Toriano, good. All the way around, yes. To the chest, good. Side control. Nice, go to mount. Posture, base, good, good, good. Start to turn him over, gift wrap. Good, get that arm across him. Look, he's giving you an armbar there too. Yeah. There it is, gift wrap him. Face low, good, take that on. There it is, go. Arm bar. Nice. Reset.
Feet smell.
One more time.
All right,
I'm ready? Go. Pass. Out and around. Moving left and right, very good. Take his back, spin to his back. Oh no, elbow escape, recover your guard. Good job, triangle. We're looking for that triangle. Good job. Cover. Good. Collar and sleeve. Nice. Arm up. Get that triangle. Pull his head down.
There we go.
Lock it up. Nice.
That is so big.
Jeez.
Good. It's pretty broad.
I didn't want to pull a rampage.
That's all right. Lift it. One more time. Double leg. Go. Go. Oh, he's gonna take me down. Pass! All the way to mount. Turn him over. Good, get that arm across. Gift wrap him, good. Turn, take him back.
Thank you.
Very good, set the hooks, get the choke. Oh no, recover your guard. Oh no, elbows in, knees in, get your leg over. Step over, high step. Good man, collar and sleeve. Good, cross collar choke. Pummel those arms inside. Good collar choke. Go for it. Pull down, elbows down. Squeeze.
Can't get it, my arm.
All right, shake hands. Hug it out. Good deal.
You got fuzzies in your hair.
All right, cool. So that's it. I think you wore my killer out, man. I don't know if he was ready. You were too good on your first day. You did all right. Thanks, Layton.
All right, I can't breathe. He probably has 12 more rounds in him. I have like half of one.
Nice. Not too bad. Thanks for coming by. I hope you had fun.
Okay.
Awesome. Mount or take her back. Whatever's available. I'm just telling you what's
we decided to let Sam give it a try really quick.
Okay, ready? All right, slap and bump.
Kelly dap.
Boom.
Bow.
All right, go.
Okay, what?
Use your legs and hands to stop him from passing you, Sam.
Sam, don't let him just walk around you. You
use your feet.
I told you how basic I am, okay? But
don't let me pass your legs.
Okay.
So if I start turning, put your feet back on me.
Yeah.
Okay. And square back up.
Okay.
Good, but he's like a third of my weight. Okay?
The fact that I'm rolling on the ground.
I'm gonna coach you. Layton, no mercy.
No mercy.
Alright, feet, Sam. Hands and feet. If he starts passing your feet, use your hands to block him and use your feet to get back in, okay? And put your feet always back in between you and him. You can block with your knees too, that's fine, but your feet are what you like. Ready, set, go!
Okay.
Good. Push on him. There you go. Bring your feet back in, Sam. Yes. Good.
You're like
Left and right, lady. You can knee cut too, buddy.
Oh, wait, I can?
Middle, yeah.
Oh,
good. Oh, push on your shoulders. Push on his shoulder, Sam. Push it with your hands, Sam.
Samantha.
Team, now get your legs back in between.
You're a martial artist, Sam. What is that?
Yes. Get your feet on him, Sam.
Yeah. Okay, okay.
Good. Yes. Push him away. Kick him. Move him. Yes.
Wait, there but how go. Do I move and kick him at the same time?
You push. It's like so.
All right, so my friend Marcus here and his son Layton just showed me who was boss. If you guys are ever in the New Orleans area, make sure you check it out right here, Science of Jiu Jitsu Academy. This is Marcus's new spot. Come and learn some cool stuff, get thrown around, get beat up a little bit, and learn some cool stuff.
Hey, thanks, Tom. Thanks, guys.